Good morning, dear children. So now we are back to our regular studies again. Let us start with the chapter number 9 of English literature book, that is A Visit to Sea World. Students, your chapter 9 is A Visit to Sea World. Today we are going to read this chapter, and in the next class I'll be explaining you this chapter. Firstly, read this chapter along with me. Have you ever been to an underwater zoo? Here, sea creatures are kept in very large aquariums. It is a wonderful way to see the world beneath the waves of the sea. Read the story of a little girl's visit to the underwater zoo. Students, we are going to read this chapter today, and then you have to write the difficult words with the help of PDF in the English Fair notebook. Let's start. Nehal's parents often took to her different kinds of amusement parks. Of all the parks she had visited, she loved going to water parks the most. Nehal loved to swim and was fond of seeing other beautiful creatures that swam in the oceans and seas of the world. She loved to watch all the TV programs that showed life underwater. After much planning, Nehal's father was taking her to SeaWorld, a new place that had opened near their home. Nehal had seen hoardings on her way to school describing the wonderful creatures that lived in SeaWorld. She was very excited and could not wait to see them herself. Early on Saturday morning, Nehal set out for SeaWorld with her father and younger brother, Rohan. Rohan loved animals too, but was little afraid of water. "Don't worry, Rohan, nothing will happen to you," said Nehal to her little brother. Nehal's father smiled as he noticed how she took care of Rohan. Their first stop in SeaWorld was the tropical fish aquarium. It was a large room with walls of glass. You could see many varieties of fish through the glass walls. It was like seeing a moving rainbow. There were fish of different colors with delicate fins and long tails. Let us move on to the next page. Fish which move around in groups are called shoals, Nehal's father explained. The shoals went everywhere together. There were shoals of black goldfish, tiny silver sharks, kissing gourami, red cape fish, and many, many more. These fish had been brought from the yellow China Sea. "They are so pretty," Nehal and Rohan shouted as they looked around excitedly, running from one glass bowl to another to see as many fish as they could. The children went to see the pool with the sea snakes. The snakes were long and shiny and swam with speed from one end of the pool to another, gliding through the water. Nehal held Rohan's hand when she saw him getting scared. Rohan whispered, "I don't like the snakes, Nehal Didi. Please let us leave." To cheer him up, they stopped for ice cream and popcorn. Soon, Rohan was smiling again. As they licked their ice cream cones, Nehal and Rohan heard loud squeals of excitement and clapping coming from another enclosure. "This is the dolphin show. We have tickets for it too," said Nehal's father. The children clapped their hands in glee. Move on to the next page, students. They made their way to the dolphin enclosure and took their seats. The show was wonderful. There were 4 dolphins in a pool. They were trained to jump high in the air. They jumped through hoops and even danced to music, bobbing their heads and waving their flippers. Finally, one of the trainers climbed onto a dolphin's back and the dolphin took her for a speedy ride. Nehal was overjoyed. "Someday, Papa, I too want to swim with dolphins," she said. So students, this was your chapter number 9, A Visit to SeaWorld. Do the practice of this chapter. Do the reading practice. Read it 3-4 times so that it should be clear to you. Pronounce all the words very clearly, and after that you have to write the difficult words with the help of PDF which is given to you in the homework in your English peer notebook. Thank you and have a nice day.